Hey guys, welcome back to this terminal series. So in the last one, we took a look at three different methods of how you can open terminal inside of macOS. And in this one, I'm going to do a little bit of housekeeping because some of you may have opened up terminal just for the first time, and you may have noticed that your actual terminal application looks slightly different than the one that I'm presenting right now. Now, if you're already familiar with this, that's okay. You can skip this video and then check out the next one. But for those of you who are curious or want to follow along as closely as you can, I will go through very briefly how this is set up and why my terminal looks the way it does. So let's take a look at this blue folder that you notice here. And if you look very closely, you'll see that it has a house on it, which denotes that it's the home directory for this user. So how do we find that out? So right now, my current home user is Williams K. So I'm going to use a command, and I know that we're not familiar with commands right now, but if you want to follow along and just see how I did this, just bear with me for a little bit. So the command I'm going to type in is pwd, which stands for present working directory. And as you can see, it'll say users, and in my instance, it's Williams K. Yours may be something different, your name or the name of your machine, or whatever you call this folder. I'm going to use another command, and this one will be clear, just to remove that content. Next up are the numbers over here. So mine will say 120 by 35 or 120 times 35. This is actually the window dimensions. So when you open up terminal, there is a default set of dimensions for the window size, and I've just adjusted mine. So I went into the preferences, and I went into profiles, and I went to window, and I changed the column size of the window to 120, and then the rows to 35. This is what's represented up here. I also did one more thing. I went into text, and I went down here to cursor, and I added a vertical bar, and I checked the blink cursor checkbox so that my vertical bar would then flash and blink as it does so here. Okay, now that that's done, there's one change that you just can't see right here. And this is usually what's called the default last login message on the Mac. So when you open up terminal for the first time, or you open up in general, there's usually a message and it says last login, and it'll give you the time, the date, a timestamp, and some other information. So what I did was I disabled this, and you would type the command touch and you would add this file. It's called the hush login file. So this is enough to silence the last login text that you normally see when you first open up terminal by default. Now I've already done this, so I'm not going to run this command. And if you don't like this setting, you can also remove this file and you just type in rm hush login, and that will also remove the file and bring back the last login message if you prefer to have that there, as you can see here. To make a note, in order for that to work, you need to actually put that in your home directory, and then you'll have to quit and restart terminal for that to take place. And then you will no longer see that last login message. Okay, and the last item in question is the primary prompt string. So this is what you see here. You don't have to change this. It's not mandatory. It's just a style thing. And, you know, at one point you will know why you'll have to change this if you want to. But for now, we're just going to type in nano, which is a simple based terminal editor. And we're going to open the location to where the file is. And this is the file in question. And inside this file, you will see that there is a variable assigned this string, and that's why you end up with this string representation at your prompt. And I will just clear this, and there we are. We're back to exactly where we started off at, and that's all the housekeeping for this video. I just wanted to address those who were curious as to how my terminal application looks a little bit different than the default and what I did to make those changes. So once again, if you found this useful, you learned something new, don't forget to subscribe, like, leave a comment and click the notification bell for future updates in the series around these videos. Thanks again, guys. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. And I will see you next time.